venture. But my name is Ashant and I have startup and run. So we took up the topic motion sensor, and we're going to keep telling people or trying to, you know, explaining people about motion sensor and motion sensor thinking about them. So let's see. So when we talk about motion sensor or any kind of sensor, the first thing that comes to our mind is what actually is a sensor. The first question that I ask in your mind is what actually is a sensor. So what is a sensor? A sensor is a device, going technically a sensor is a device that detects the presence of any physical property, and these properties can be heat, motion, or sound, and all those. And let me put it in this way, make it easy for you people to understand. A sensor is an electronic device which in sense that just we human can. And going further, sensor can be divided, can be categorized into two parts, passive and active sensor. And Sathya can explain you what passive and active sensor.
It basically works on the principle of electromagnetic signal or echo principle. Firstly, a signal is transmitted and it hits the object, and then it gets reversed back and is received by the receiver. Through this, we can calculate the time, and by the distance formula, we can calculate the distance between the object and the receiver. Now, second comes the passive sensors. It works on the principle of infrared energy concept, and every object on Earth radiates energy. So this energy or energy change is accepted or received by the receiver.
Next, there are some pics. We would like to show you people how this sensor actually looks like. So we can just see what it looks like. Next is passive sensor and non-visible.
Now comes the type of infrared passive sensors, PIS. This works on the principle of protection. It is the most commonly used motion sensor technology in home security systems. Firstly, there is a grid type system. It works on the principle of protective grid. If a moving object blocks the or too many grid zones, then the sensors are tripped. There is a major change in energy levels. Then the sensors are tripped and it detects the object.
Between the object and the visible. towards the object and measure its reflection of a moving object.
Now third comes the vibration. It detects the vibration. Every object on earth produces vibration and it detects it by the receiver. And it detects the object which is in the designated area or not.
And next is video motion sensor. So these are nothing but the combination of video cameras and our sensors. So what is the use of this video motion sensors? It's just that when you see a normal CCTV cameras, what it does is, it takes the footage 24/7 hours. So what's there's nothing wrong with that, but it takes a lot of memory. So just to reduce that, we have combined the motion sensors with the video cameras. What happens is this camera starts recording only when it sees some motion. So it saves a lot of footage as well as you can go for a little bit of technical energy. And next is he's going to explain you what tell you some uses of the motion sensor and so on.
Some main uses of motion sensors are to open and close the automatic doors and to turn on and off automatic bars, taps and toilets, to turn on light when the man enters the room, or to control the ATM display, or widely used in gaming
industry. Okay, so next slide will be our last slide. So, what's the name? Vijay? Look, man. This is something which I have worked on it as a I need to show it, right? Show it. Very hard to answer. That's just the angry part.
Okay.
You were from the wrong. I love you.
Okay.